So once your left shruti is absolutely jammed, you lose complete discretion of the chakra here, which we call it Hamsa chakra. And then you do not know what is destructive, what is constructive. You start accepting mostly the destructive thing if your left shruti is bad. Escape. So what? What wrong? That is how violence has come. That is how all kind of cheating, corruption has come. What's wrong? Because if you do anything wrong, you put it there, finished, stored up. Again you do anything, you put it there. And till you become absolutely immune to all destructive action, you go on. So to get out of it, what to do? To get out of this horrible state where you do not feel any thing wrong, what is the thing? Only is to take to sadhana in a right fashion. First of all, you must face yourself. If you start facing yourself, you will realize that you have committed a mistake. So this is the mistake I have committed, doesn't matter. I am not going to feel guilty about it. If I ever have to do this, I will not do it. And I am not guilty for whatever has happened, is the past finished. With this faith in yourself, you can definitely get rid of your left shruti. The problem is, even if I tell you something, I am worried that you start feeling guilty about it also. I mean, I am telling you for something for your correction. Then you start guilty, mother is saying so, see, I did this and that, but that you did. At this moment, what I am telling you, never to do it again. And face it. Whatever you did is finished and gone and is forgiven completely. Otherwise Vishnu Maya will take over. This is very important because one side is a leela, it's a play, and it's all the world is beautiful. The another side is the guilt. So we think that by just feeling guilty we are solving all our problems, and this side we are enjoying ourselves, and this the guilt part is just like a storehouse of a garbage being put there. But we never think this garbage, what it is wrong it is doing to us. And this is what it is, that Vishnu Maya has to burn this garbage. Then she works in her own ways, in her own Maya ways, and so many things happen. Like there was a lady, and she was very right-sided. She used to dominate everyone, but nobody dared tell her that, because if you tell her, she would come back on you. So nobody wanted to tell her what's wrong with her. They said, all right, let it be now. But I told her that, see, you are very right-sided, you are dominating everyone, everybody is frightened of you. So she said, no, mother, I am not. I said, all right, I am telling you. You better believe me or you are in for trouble. And that very day, she was getting down from the staircase and she fell from top to bottom, she came down. And all her right side, she came to, mother, see, my right hand is broken, my right leg is broken, this is broken, that is broken. I said, then you know what happened? I now know why it has happened. Then I cured her, she was all right. But what I am trying to tell you, that she wouldn't listen to me. So the right-sided people have a special capacity to put everything here. So I always say that it is the by-product of ego. Those people who try to dominate, who try to be angry, try to control everyone, they put it down there. And then the whole thing works against them. This is to be understood in a very serious manner, that feeling guilty is not that you are harming yourself, but you are harming all others. Also this Vishnu Maya gets very upset with two other things. One of the things is smoking. If you smoke too much, then this Vishnu Maya gets very angry. She is the one who then causes cancer. She can spoil your throat. I mean, all kinds of ear, nose, throat problems can come in with the smoking. Because she doesn't like that smoke. She once, twice, thrice. But once you start smoking, then after some time, oh, what's wrong? They will quote, such and such man who is 83, he still smokes. See, quoting like this, they have ideas like that. Then you have also some cinema heroes, such and such man, see, he murdered his wife, he's not, see, he's going along. So we should also murder. We should also smoke. So the all ideals which have destroyed themselves become our ideals. And we start exactly doing what they are doing, without knowing that how they are destroyed, we'll be also destroyed. So this understanding about Vishnu Maya's powers should be there with us. That if we try to continue with our mistakes and putting them here, then first thing we become vulnerable to all kinds of diseases. With that if you have smoking, you can become also very much vulnerable to cancer of the throat. Another thing which people do not know is the mantras. If you go on saying any mantra, I mean in India there are people who will every day morning get up and say some mantra for about say 100 times. Some say it at least 300 times, 500 times. They go on measuring mantra, 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 mantra like that. Now she is the mantrika. She is the one who gives the power to the mantra. Now if you are not connected to this divine power, then there's a short circuiting take place. And if you go on saying this mantra, you develop all the troubles of the throat, throat cancer, you can develop also stomach in the stomach problems because it is Krishna and Vishnu are the same. You might develop also the problem of Virata. Because you are reciting a mantra like this, you see, a telephone, if it is not connected, I go on using it, the telephone will go out of order. In the same way, if you are doing wrong mantras, in the sense that the mantras which are said before your connection with the Divine, then they can spoil your left Vishuddhi very much. This is the style they use in India. Supposing you are a businessman in India. Now, you are a big businessman, you have made lot of money, now you feel guilty about it. Because you have made by bad means also, by all kinds of black market and all sorts of things. So they'll make a big temple of Vishnu. Not Vishuddhi, but they'll make a very big temple of Sri Vishnu. And they will create a kind of image that they are great religious people. Or they'll have khairat, means they will distribute food to people, or distribute some things to people and feel satisfied. Here you go on committing any amount of sins, any amount of nonsense. And then out of that money you make a little contribution to Sri Vishnu, thinking that Sri Vishnu will be very happy and will not punish them. But he is Kubera, what can you give it to him? He is the Kubera. He gives you all the money, he does everything. So how can you give anything to Kubera, who is himself the lord of wealth. It's a very common thing in India, like there was a Bhudan thing. I knew of a man who was very corrupt, very bad person. I mean, really, he was really very, very bad man. And he had taken away so much land from the poor farmers and all that. So he gave one land to Mahatma Gandhi. And this land, this Bhudan land was known. It was, I think, Vinobaji gave. This land was so bad that you could not put even cactus there. And he was telling everybody, I've given so much land to Bhudan, I've given so much land to Bhudan. So trying to sort of justify himself for taking all the land from the poor and lynching them and then to do this kind of a generosity. So this is another escape people have, that do what you like and ultimately be generous. This kind of gracious covering of your mistakes can be very misleading. It doesn't work with Vishnu Maya. She knows you out and out. And if you try all these tricks with her, she will show her own powers. I would say all our left side problems come because of Vishnu Maya power. She punishes you, as well as she exposes, as well as she gives you light, as well as she corrects you. With all these powers of Vishnu Maya, we should be very thankful that today we are celebrating her special puja, because I think it is one of the curses of the West, especially of Americans, to feel guilty. So today you all have to promise in your heart, and the mantra is, now she also understands English perhaps, you can say that, Mother, I am not guilty at all. That's all. If that is said, she will be very happy, I am not guilty at all, I am not going to feel guilty. Once you stop feeling guilty, you will not do wrong things. Because how will you manage? Because you are not doing, you cannot put it as guilt. So what's the use of doing anything wrong? If you do wrong, it comes on your head. You cannot put it in your left visuddhi. So you won't do anything wrong. You will immediately understand that if I have to do wrong, I have to face it. But if there's a space here kept where you can put your guilt for your wrongdoings available, then you don't mind so much. Supposing somebody has a small house, no place to store, then somebody brings something and says, no, no space here. I am already very full. It's like that. So the best thing is to have no guilt at any cost. I will have no guilt. If I have done mistake, all right, I'll admit I've done the mistake. And I'll have no guilt at all about it. I'll face it. You'll be surprised, you'll stop doing wrong things. Definitely you'll stop, because there's no space left. So this is very important today, to do Vishnu Maya's thing. And I'm sure now, very happy with the tour of America. This time I'm really happy, because I think it has worked in most of the places very well. And if it has not worked, one should not feel guilty, but face the problem, why it has not worked. And the problem lies with Sahajyogis and nobody else. Shouldn't blame anybody else for it. Just see yourself what mistakes you must have committed. Could be a small or a big mistake, whatever it is. Face it. There's no harm in saying, I've done mistake. But if you say, sorry, means it goes there straight forward. No, I have committed a mistake. To admit that is very gracious, very beautiful, and very kind to yourself for your benevolence. In Sahaja Yoga is one of the biggest mantras for all the Western people. They should all the time saying to all the trees, all the nature around, I am not guilty. Your ecological problem will improve. because then you won't do wrong things to spoil your ecology. You'll be careful, because you spoil it and you feel guilty. Oh, I should not have done this. Oh, I should not. But why did you do in the first place, is the point. So now, next time you're not going to do it. So many of our problems will be solved if you face them and correct them boldly. It's possible for Sahaja Yogis because you're separated from your being, you're away from it. You can see your body, you can see your mind, you can see your ego, you can see all of those things, and you know how to put them right. You are not that, you know. So you are the Spirit. With the light of the Spirit you can correct all these things. But this guilt is something where it stops you completely from correcting or doing anything better about it or bringing any constructive thing to your own mind. This will solve many problems for America as well as for all the Western world. Same with the Indians, that they should not think that if they are generous a little bit, they can get rid of their mistakes, you see, they have to face it. It's a different style. Indians are very clever, you know, they know how to find excuses and escapes. But after all, it is Vishnu Maya. She will show you that there is no escape, just face it. There's no need to condemn yourself, don't need to in any way degrade yourself or to feel inferior. But to be superior as the Spirit, I see. Like I would say, all right, Nirmala, I see you very well, you did this. Separate yourself from yourself. You can talk on the mirror, you can go to the river and talk there, or you can go to an ocean and tell them that, see, I've done this mistake and now I'm not going to do it. You can make promises to all these elements. Once you make these promises, this Vishnu Maya will receive the message and she won't enter into any one of these elements to disturb you. So you have to go and tell the ocean that, all right, America is not guilty for whatever they have done. Say it like that. If you say, it's all right, not other people. Because I told you, your genetics have changed, you are different people. Whatever you say, Vishnu Maya will always believe in and everything will work out very well. But this is a special time, as I told you before, where we call it is the Krita Yuga, where between the Kali Yuga and Satya Yuga this time is so important that whatever mistakes we have committed, we have to pay for it. It's a karma phala. It won't work out by just putting it here. So one has to get to realization, change the genetics completely, and then you can go and tell the nature that, all right, we are not guilty now, we've got our realization. And it will work. I'm sure so many of catastrophes of this country can be averted by you, Sahaja Yogis. May God bless you.